mal là que je monte direct habituellement. Là, il n'y a pas de bootpack, ça fait un petit bout que je suis allé, mais habituellement, je me ramasse avec une belle petite trelle. Puis éventuellement, des fois, j'ai même plus besoin de mettre de raquettes. Là, quand je passe 4-5 fois, je descends puis je peux remonter direct juste en botte. Là. Alors, il y a tous ces arbres-là qui sont tombés. Ils étaient tous debout, eux autres. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Il y en a plein, là, c'est en diagonale. Cet été, quand ça va fondre, je vais venir nettoyer ça. Là. Je vais tout coucher sur la terre. Les conditions ont comme leur propriété un peu. Tu sais, des fois, full profond, ça fait que je vais chercher le terrain le plus à pic que je connais dans ma zone. Sinon, quand c'est, disons, juste genre ça de neige, tu sais, aujourd'hui, il va falloir que j'essaie de trouver genre le moins à pic puis que je vienne passer de droite à gauche de la montagne plutôt que de descendre vraiment en ligne droite. Là.
Growing up, I was always attracted by the woods, by, you know, being in the forest. And when my parents would bring me camping, I was having the best time. And I spent a lot of time at this cabin that I just like really, really enjoyed my time there. And when it was time to move out and find my own spot, instead of going towards like a more urban environment, I decided to go in the trees, in the woods, and like having more of a cabin life than like actual like neighborhood vibe. Yeah, ever since I started snowboarding, I've always ridden in my backyard. We had mini slopes on both sides of my parents' house, and with my brother, any free time that we had, we would go back there and we'd create these mini features. And I guess 30 years later, I'm still doing the same thing here.
C'est qui en premier?
Sometimes I go on trips and I bring back some like no trespassing signs from other places, or this one says beware of dog, even though we don't have a dog at all. But I just actually really like the look of these little signs. I found a lot of really good dirt here just from this tree here that was fallen, and it uncovered like a really nice pit of pretty super good dirt. So it's right there, it's like 10 feet over. Right here is a little step down into this little pocket. I'm gonna cut this branch real quick.
Right here is a mini, like, distance booter. This one you don't want to case too much. Let's keep going.
There's a lot of time that goes into trail building and also making sure that the forest is kind of open, and when a tree falls or when 5-10 fall, I go and try to clean it up and try to fill any hole or any type of kink. I also try to create like jumps and fun bumps for the snow to collect and make, you know, a perfect little opening.
Working on this uphill climb that starts from my house and gets like to the top of the hill. So yeah, right now, just today, there's this little switchback that's kind of being pretty wet, and we're gonna fix it, and I'm gonna add a little bridge.
I get into this really happy place when I'm doing it. Like, I get super calm, it's almost like a form of meditation. Like, I'm just there, you know, I'm concentrating with what's in front of me, and I just, like, for me, it's like one of my favorite place to be is back there in the woods with like a bunch of tools and just making sure that when I go down it, it's gonna be awesome. What I like the most is you see it in your head, and as you're building, you're kind of like riding it in your head and thinking about the physics of it. And then when you finally strap in and do the test, it's cool when like your speed worked and like the distance was spot on. I think that's like some of the best feelings ever. We'll be right back.
Il en veut trop.
Hey, c'est fini. Le manège est fini, mon chum.